guys, welcome back to another video on my channel. So in today's video, I'm gonna talk all about raw diets for dogs. It's not gonna be reptile related. A lot of you guys were interested in how I'm doing this, and I've learned a lot lately about raw diets, so I just wanted to go over all of it with you guys for anyone that could be interested in this. So yeah, I'm just gonna jump right into it. So I recently did make a video about everything that I feed my dog, and I have changed things significantly since then because I learned a lot more since then. So I basically wanted to update that video because I realized that I was actually doing something really wrong that you shouldn't be doing, and that was mixing raw food with kibble. This is something that you absolutely shouldn't do just because it's not good for your dog. It probably can give them a tummy ache. Chacho's poop was like really mushy and just not very healthy, and it's because kibble requires a different digestive process than raw meat. So raw meat basically digests quicker than kibble, which is actually takes longer, and it's just a longer process. So by feeding both of those food items at the same time, you're actually slowing the digestive system down, and it's leaving the bacteria of that raw meat in their gut, and it's just not very good for them. It might give them a tummy ache, so it's just not something you should do. If you're gonna feed kibble, feed kibble. If you're gonna do raw, do raw. Just do them separately if you wanna offer both into their diet, but never mix them. So now that I've touched upon that, I'm gonna just go over basically why I wanted to do the raw diet for dogs, because this is something that's completely new to me. My boyfriend, before we got a dog, said that we should do the raw diet. I had never heard of this before, and I honestly just thought the whole idea of feeding raw just sounded absurd. It just sounded so unnatural because, like, I've grown up seeing people just feed kibble my entire life. For the past 100 years, that's what people have been doing, is feeding this preserved diet. And it's actually just not the most natural thing for your dogs. It's just, it seems like the most natural to us as humans because it's what we've grown up seeing and understanding how people take care of their dogs by always feeding kibble. But that's not how dogs have survived all of these years, and it's not the healthiest option for them. So after doing loads of research and realizing how unnatural it is to feed them kibble, which is basically just like burnt crumbs filled with preservatives, it just sounds like a nightmare to me personally because I have Crohn's disease and I can't eat things with preservatives in them whatsoever. Like anything that comes in like a bag or a box, I usually can't eat it because of those preservatives, and it just makes me so sick. So because I can feel the effects of what those toxic things are, I just absolutely don't want to consume it myself, and I don't want to give it to my dog either. A lot of kibble also contains corn, wheat, and soy, which are just really, really bad allergens for your dog. And I mean, dogs can survive on kibble. It has happened for the past 100 years, but they have developed so many more diseases and health issues because of it. And it's just not the most healthy alternative to be feeding your dog, in my opinion. So that is why I made the decision to switch over to raw. But I'm not fully on the raw diet. I'm still learning about it. So I'm gonna cover everything on how you can feed raw and the steps to take. And then I'm gonna tell you guys exactly what I'm feeding my dog right now and my situation, because I'm not fully on raw yet. I do wanna get there, but we're still easing into it. And I have my handy notebook here because I have so many notes on all of this. I want to make sure I get all of this right because switching over to this diet involves a lot of research, and I just wanted to make sure I was doing it right. So yeah, I have notes. So for a balanced raw diet for your dog, it should contain 70% meat, 10% organs, 10% bones, and 10% vegetables and fruits. So obviously meat is, they're carnivores, they require the meat, so that should be 70% of their diet. So when it comes to the 10% of organs, there are different kinds of organs that do different things in their diet. The muscle organs are the hearts, the gizzard, the trachea, the lungs, the tongue, and then there are the other organs that are more of like the multivitamins in their diet, and that's going to be the liver, the kidney, the spleen, the brain. So something that I think is so important that I learned from this is that a dog's diet actually requires 10% bone. And feeding a kibble diet, you do not give them bone whatsoever. That's something that they're just completely lacking in their diet, and they need 10% of that. The bones are a huge source of calcium that the dogs require, and it's also very, very important for their teeth. A lot of dogs that are on a kibble diet end up losing their teeth. They need them surgically removed, which is thousands of dollars, because they don't like their teeth being brushed, but they have to because of kibble and all the crumbs on their teeth. Some people say that kibble actually brushes your dog's teeth. It doesn't. It's literally just like crumbs on their teeth, and that sits there and just rots their teeth. So unless your dog enjoys their teeth being brushed, which they probably don't because that's really unnatural, the best thing to give them is actually bones. So the most important thing with bones in a raw diet is that it has to be raw meat and raw bones for your dog, because when it's raw, it's actually chewy. But if you cook the bones or the meat, then that's when the bone tends to splinter and can really, really injure your dog if they were to eat that and potentially kill them. So that's something that I was really nervous about, because feeding bones just seemed like such a no-no, because you can't just like have a chicken wing or something and give it to your dog because it's cooked and that's what makes it so dangerous. But in the raw form, it's completely natural and they're able to chew that up and digest it with ease. So that's something that is required, and it's the best thing for their teeth. It actually cleans their teeth for them. So it's just very, very important for their dental health. And then they also require the 10% of veggies and fruits. I'm going to go over this a little bit later. It's something that's not really that important, because usually what dogs do is they eat other animals that are eating the plants and vegetation and fruits. So that's already digested within the other animal, and then they consume it and they do get some of those nutrients. So it's not a huge component of the dog diet. We may think that we have to incorporate way more fruits and veggies into their diet, similar to like our diet, but they actually don't. Remember that they are carnivores, so it's just a very, very small part of their diet. So a huge question about feeding raw is how much to feed your dog, because obviously dogs come in all different shapes and sizes. So I have everything written down right here in my notes so that way you guys can figure out exactly how much you should be feeding your dog. So you have to weigh your dog and then figure out the portions to make sure that it's a good percent. Only 2 to 3% of your dog's weight, that's how much you should be feeding them for the day. It is different if you have puppies, so I'm going to go over all of those percentages right now. So a puppy that is 7 to 10 weeks old should have 10% of their body weight. 10 to 16 weeks old should have 8% of their body weight. 16 to 20 weeks old should have 7% of their body weight. 20 to 24 weeks old should have 6% of their body weight. 24 to 36 weeks old should have 5% of their body weight. And then 36 to 56 weeks old should have 4% of their body weight. And then after that, it just goes to adult size, which is 2 to 3% of your dog's body weight. So when you're first starting to feed raw, it seems like, I don't know why, because I mean, we've grown up in a world where everyone just feeds kibble. It seems so unnatural for us to feed raw meat to our dogs. But that is actually what's most natural for them. A lot of people are concerned about the health issues and salmonella. A lot of dogs actually carry salmonella, and it's not something that's going to harm them whatsoever. And they have a lot of bacteria in their gut to be able to break down all of these nasty things that humans aren't able to eat, because they eat raw meat. It's what they are built to do. So humans obviously can't eat those things, but dogs can. So it's just something to keep in mind, just to make you guys feel a little bit more comfortable, because I know how wrong it feels, because I was terrified when I started. One of the best things to start with is actually chicken throats. And this is one of the best things that you could give your dog for their teeth. It totally just like brushes their teeth. It's the best thing for them to chew on. It's nice and small. So if you're easing into the raw diet, it's a really good small thing to try out first, maybe for the first week or something, and see how your dog does. I was really worried because I have a smaller breed dog, and I just didn't know if he'd be able to handle it, but he ate it like a champ, and he eats them every night, and he absolutely loves chicken throats. So that's like a really easy protein to start off with. So that's what I would recommend if you're just starting off and you're really nervous about it and you just want to ease your dog into the raw diet. So some of the options to feed your dog, there's so many options, guys. So I wrote them down because I don't want to miss any. There's chicken, turkey, quail, venison, pork, beef, lamb, bison, duck, and rabbit. So there are just so many different things that you could be feeding your dog. Some people find it easiest just to pick like 4 main ones and switch off between those within the month. But again, it's good to offer new things. And also be aware of if your dog has any allergies or anything, because obviously you don't want to be feeding those foods and get your dog sick. So yeah, just keep that in mind. So there are some common vitamins that are missing from a dog's diet. This isn't just for like raw meat, but this is for kibble for most of the time. But there are ways to supplement and make sure that the dog is getting these vitamins in their raw diet by feeding these options. So I'm just gonna run through it really quick. So vitamin E is something that is left out quite often in the dog diet. And a way to supplement this into the raw diet is by feeding wheat germ oil. Another one that is left out is zinc. So red meat, goat milk, cottage cheese, yogurt, and eggs is a great way to incorporate zinc into your dog's raw diet. Magnesium is another one that's left out. A way to incorporate this is actually by green tripe. I haven't tried this yet, so it's something that I still need to incorporate into my dog's diet. Another one is iodine, and a way to supplement this is with kelp, eggs, or mushrooms. Yes, dogs can have mushrooms. Some people are just so weirded out by that and they think it's dangerous. Obviously, they have to be from a store. You don't want to just pick up a random mushroom from outside because it could be toxic and that's dangerous. So anything that is in a store and sold in a store that's safe for a human is also going to be safe for a dog regarding the mushrooms. Choline is another one that's left out, and this can be supplemented with fish, which you should be feeding them one time a week. Going to go over that a little later. Vitamin D is another one that's left out, and you can supplement with goat milk, mushrooms, yogurt, or cottage cheese. A lot of these options are going to be incorporating a lot of the same vitamins. Omega-3 is another one that's left out, and you can add this with fish oils. Some people use fish oil pills, but I've heard that that's actually kind of dangerous and you can overdo it by adding a pill every single day. So some people like to just add the fish one time a week just to make sure that they're getting those omega-3s rather than adding a pill. Amino acids are usually left out as well, and this can be supplemented with fish, chicken, eggs, lamb, and spinach. I also wrote down here that spinach and kale help the digestive system. Green beans are a good option as well. So as I mentioned before, dogs are able to digest raw meats way easier than human beings, obviously, because it's made for them. It's what they were made to do. So there are some things to keep in mind, though, when handling the raw meat to make sure that it's safe for your dogs, because there are certain meats that do carry bacteria that can potentially make your dog sick. And there is one easy way to resolve this issue, and that is by freezing the meat for at least 24 hours before feeding it to your dog. So this just means when you buy it at the store, you want to bring it home, put it in your freezer for 24 hours, then let it thaw out, and then you can serve it to your dog rather than just giving it to them right away. Some of the foods to watch out for with those bacteria that you should absolutely freeze are actually pork, venison, and lamb. So I've noticed that chicken and turkey seem to be safe, but if you just want to play the safe route, it's best to just freeze all of your meats for 24 hours and then thaw it out and then serve it to your dog, and just get on a system of doing this just to make sure that if there is any potential dangers in that meat, you're going to be freezing it out and making it safe for your dog before offering it to them. So there are 10 rules regarding the raw diet, and I'm going to cover these really quick. I actually found these from a website. I'm going to put the link in my description because this website was so helpful and it just really goes into depth with helping with the raw diet and easing yourself into it and just educating yourself on it. So I'm going to put that in the description for you guys to check out if you're interested in finding out more information. But the number one rule on their list is that raw diet must have calcium. So the calcium can be included into the dog's raw diet through the bones. It's very important. That should be 10% of their diet anyway. Not only the bones, but other ways that you can add calcium would actually be with eggshells. So you can feed raw eggs to your dogs, and you can actually crunch up the shells and give them the shell as well. They will eat it, and it's just extra calcium for them. So the second one on their list is organs are the multivitamins. So that's something that's really important. One thing I do want to mention, though, liver is a great multivitamin, but it is not something that you should be feeding to your dog frequently, because if you overdo it, it can be very unhealthy for them. So if you're gonna be feeding liver, it should not be a staple part of their diet. I would say to offer it maybe once a week, and that would be totally fine. But definitely don't be feeding liver every single day, because that's not very good for your dogs. And over time, they will have some negative effects. So number three is muscle meat is the foundation. So this is really important. You want to be picking out really lean meats for your dogs. You don't want to be having a lot of fat on them. If there's skin on the meat, pick it off. Don't feed it to them because it's just really fatty. Definitely want to be giving them very lean and muscular meats because it's the best thing for them. Which brings us to number four, which is to watch out for fat. So again, if there's any skin on the meat, I would recommend to pick it off. Just don't feed it to them because it's just way too fatty for them. Number five is to don't get hung up on fruits and vegetables. So as I mentioned earlier, this isn't something that's such a huge component for the dog's diet. It is something that you can add. Dogs actually can have a harder time digesting some types of fruits and vegetables, such as carrots. Carrots are great for dogs, but sometimes if you feed a raw carrot, like Chacho has literally pooped out a raw carrot, like still in its like natural form, because it's just harder to digest. So a little trick that you can try out is actually to just blend up some fruits and vegetables and then pour that onto their raw meat. This trick works really great because it's a way of replicating how they would be eating in the wild, because when they're eating another animal that has consumed the fruits and vegetables, it's already digested. So when you're blending it up, it's kind of like an already digested meal with all of those vitamins and nutrients. So that's just a way of adding it in and making it easier on their digestive system to be able to absorb that nutrients. And again, if you're going to be doing that, make sure that you're feeding fruits and vegetables that are safe for dogs. Just Google it. Make sure that you're not offering them anything that is potentially toxic. Number six is to keep it starch-free. So potatoes, peas, and grains, these things are just not great for your dogs and they can be fattening over time, especially grains. So this is something that I actually need to fix in my dog's diet because I give him a lot of rice at nighttime and that's like one of his staples. And I think it's just way too much for him. So I'm gonna be cutting back on the grains because he just has way too much in his diet. So that's just something to be aware of because a lot of the grain-free dog food kibbles, they have like the peas, they have a lot of starches like potatoes and peas, and these actually can cause heart issues in your dog later on. So that's why a lot of people are avoiding the grain-free diets now. So that's just something to keep in mind. Starches are just not the greatest for your dog. Number seven is variety counts. So as I mentioned earlier, it's good to pick like four good proteins that you're going to be feeding your dog, but it is great every now and then to offer them something new. Variety goes a really long way in giving them extra vitamins and nutrients into their diet. So number eight is balance over time. So this basically, what it talked about in the article anyway, was saying that no diet is fully balanced. Like there's no way that you're just like checking every single thing in your human diet to make sure that you're having everything. It's just a matter of whether or not your dog is healthy. So I would recommend, no matter what you're doing, if you're just switching over to the raw diet, make sure you bring your animal to the vet. Make sure that you get them checked out and they're healthy and they have everything that they should be getting. They aren't lacking in any vitamins and nutrients. If they are, then you know where to supplement and improve. So, I mean, there is no perfect diet, but there is a way to make sure that you can be offering so much to your dog to be able to balance everything and give them everything that they truly need to thrive. Number nine is to feed fish one time a week. So I have seen so many people offer their dog fish oil, but in this article, it's saying that that's actually kind of dangerous. And again, it has like preservatives. And if you're offering that every single day, it's not good for your dog over time. So it's better to just make sure that your dog is getting those omega-3s by offering the raw fish one time a week. There are different options that you could be using. There's sardines, smelts, herring, mackerel, cod, anchovies, and sardines. One thing that I really want to talk about is salmon. So salmon is not something that I would recommend to feed raw because it seems very difficult and risky. Salmon carries a lot of bacteria and it's really dangerous for your dog unless it is frozen for, I believe, 7 full days. And even after doing that, sometimes it depends on the temperature of your freezer. So if your freezer isn't at the correct temperature, those bacteria can still be there. So it just seems overall way too risky. So if you do want to feed your dog salmon, I would cook it. Don't give it to them raw. There's so many other options that you can do raw. Another thing to look out for is extra salt. They can have a little bit of sea salt, but whatever fish you're going to be buying, if it's in like a can or something, just make sure there's not a ton of salt in it because that's obviously not going to be healthy. Then number 10 on their list is to relax, because this article is so helpful in understanding in that switching over to the raw diet can be so intimidating, and I've totally felt that. I included the kibble for so long because it's just like ingrained in my mind that I should be feeding kibble because that's where all the nutrients is, but it's not. Like the kibble is just like I'm sorry, guys, but it's kind of garbage. It's like literally just like crumbs of preservatives with like some stuff that they need that just barely keeps them alive. And it's just not good for them. So it's just not something I would recommend. I think home cooked is so much better for your dogs. And then the ultimate thing would be raw, because the raw form has the most nutrients for them. So it just seems like the best alternative. But again, that is my decision. You guys don't have to do what I'm doing, but I assume if you're watching this video, you are a little bit interested in the raw diet. So hopefully this was able to help you out a little bit. I do want to talk a little bit about what I'm feeding my dog, because the raw diet can be very expensive, and that is something that a lot of people don't want to do the raw diet because they're just so intimidated by the price tag. And that's something that I have struggled with as well, because I would love to just go to a company like WeFeedRaw.com, because if you're able to afford that, that would make things so much easier, because they balance everything out for you. They ship everything to your door, but it's just very pricey, and you have to order at least 20 pounds or something of meat in order to get it to your house. I don't even have the space in my freezer for all of that meat, so it's just not a good option for me right now. Eventually in the future, I would love to go that route. But because that's just out of my price range right now, I'm just doing other alternatives. So what I do instead is I feed the Instinct raw diet for breakfast for Chacho every single morning. He does get a little bit of like raw turkey every now and then, or raw chicken throats. And then at nighttime, I give him his cooked meal. So I've showed you guys in the past what I've done with that. I like to just change it up every week. Again, I do think I add way too many grains to his diet, so I'm gonna be reducing that in the future. And then I like to give him lamb. I basically just look out whatever I can find at the grocery store, and that's what I'm going to be freezing for 24 hours, and then I feed it to him raw. So it seems to be going really well. I think that it gives him, well, obviously my dog just has a lot of energy, but I think that the raw diet definitely gives him a lot of energy. His coat just seems very silky and shiny and beautiful. Something that I appreciate the most is actually his poop. When you feed your dog raw food, their poops are so, so small and just solid and perfect. I sound like such a freak, but it's so true, because like for the longest time, Chacho just had like really mushy poops, huge, huge mushy poops. And it was just a nightmare to clean up. And now that he's been eating raw, it's just like really solid and nice, healthy poops. And I just very appreciative of that. So I definitely like my choice of switching over to raw. Again, I am still feeding a little bit of home cooked, but eventually I would like to eliminate that from his diet as well and just go full on raw. So I hope that this video was helpful. Please let me know what your thoughts are. If you have anything to add, I really appreciate the feedback. I hope that this video was able to help somebody out. I know it's a lot of information, so hopefully this video isn't way too long. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I appreciate you guys, and I will see you in the next video.